Hello, my name is Soumya and I welcome you to Revise 2, the learning platform. In the previous video lectures, we have seen that what is Coulomb's law and how we have derived Coulomb's law in scalar as well as vector form, and also seen Coulomb's law in terms of position vector. So in today's video lecture, we are going to cover not exactly a numerical, but yes, it is like a small derivation and is asked in question papers very often. So what we see is that the question states that show that Coulomb's law obeys Newton's third law. So what we have to show is that Coulomb's law obeys what? Newton's third law. So before knowing this, we should know that what is Coulomb's law and what is Newton's third law. Fine. So first, let us discuss what is Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law actually tells you the relation between the electrostatic force and charges. Means we have discussed that force, like in scalar form, we have discussed it was this. But in vector form, this force was how much? It was k q1 q2 by magnitude of r cube into your r vector. Right? This was what was the formula. While for Newton's third law, what we say is that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Right, this is what the Newton's third law states. So, keep this equation in mind, fine. And we have discussed these equations in terms of your position vector also. So, let us see that what this equation is actually saying. Right, let us derive. So, the solution of this question is that, first of all, we are relating. So, we are assuming that F1, 2 is what you can see two charges. These are two unlike charges, right? So what will happen? They will move towards each other. They will attract. So there will be a development of some attractive force between the two. So that force, which is experienced by body Q1. Body Q1 means this is the charge Q1 and it is a positive charge. So let F12 be the force which is experienced by, right, this is the force experienced on Q1 due to Q2. Similarly, let F21 be the force on Q2 due to Q1. So we have noted that F12 is the force at charge 1 due to the presence of charge 2 and vice versa for F21. Right. So what is happening over here is we can write, we already know, we have derived the expression for the position vector. So what we can write is the force F12 can be written as K Q1 Q2 by your R12 square into R12. So what I have done is, you might be wondering why not Q? So we have seen already that in this derivation we can write it in this form. When you are not substituting the value of the position of this unit vector R. Right? So I have did the same thing. This is the value for my F12. What I can write now, this F12 can be written as what? It can be written as A, Q1, Q2 by R21 whole cube into, but how I am writing this, you might be wondering that how this is equal to R21. So let us first discuss what is happening. We can write it as Q1, Q2 by R21 square into R12. Why I have written this as 21? So always remember, over here what we are considering is, we are considering that R12 is equal to R21. Why? Because both of them are representing what? They are representing the magnitude. And magnitude in this case for the two is same. So we can write this as this also. So the final value of F12 will be equal to what? It will be equal to your, but this R cap, this R12 cap, both of their magnitudes are same for R12 and R21. But what is happening? One of them is acting opposite, right? Both of them are moving towards each other. The direction of the two is not the same. So the position vector is written as the negative of the other. Fine. So keep these two points in mind. Keeping these two points in mind, we can write that this equation can be written as this. y negative because I have substituted the value for r unit vector y2 as minus of r unit vector 2, right, from this. So this is my formula for r12. But now if you check this, what is happening? This is the exact formula for f21, right? This is the exact formula. So what we can write over here is that the value of the force f12 is minus of the value of the force f21. If you will derive the value for f12, you will get this value, that k, q1, q2, what we will use for f21, r21 to the power this, right, into r21 unit vector. So this is what we are getting, but in a negative sign. So this is the final statement that we are arising to. And what it is depicting? It is depicting that every action, our action is what? Our action is F12, right? So due to the action of F12, there is some reaction, right? Which is F21. And how is that reaction? The negative sign represents that it is an opposite type of reaction. So, if our third law of Newton stated, right, that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So, this is all for today. Thank you. Hope that you have understood this question.